What's good, everybody? It's your man, Annoying TV. What I like this year, NBA 2K21, is the new pie charts they added. You get different varieties of choices that you get to choose in NBA 2K. I loved it a lot. Also, the 2K beach, man. The neighborhood beach is one of the best things they added. It's a whole new look, whole new environment. It's lit, man.
2K21, amazing.
Well, there's always a little extra motivation for a team playing in front of their home fans. And the Heat definitely looked motivated as they came into the building. Our camera circling high above American Airlines Arena on this beautiful night, giving you a terrific view of our location here in Miami. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan along courtside with Brett Perry and Greg Anthony. We've got David Aldridge on the sideline. Hey, Dave.
Kevin, good evening. It has been a hand-in-glove fit with Jimmy Butler in Miami. Coach Eric Spoelstra said he should have been in a Heat uniform long ago. It feels like he's about what we're about, and vice versa. Butler said, everything about this organization fits me. I'm home. Kevin?
That warrior mentality, the common thread there, D.A., thanks so much. And a look at the starters for the Hornets. Washington and Zeller are in the middle. Ogier and Monk, they're the backcourt. And it's Batum at the three spot. And for Miami, Bam Adebayo is out there with Jake Crowder. And there's Jimmy Butler. And it's Dragic in the front guard. So the Hornets win the tip. Suns making some changes here. Greg, not all drafts are the same in terms of talent. 2019 was a year to remember.
No doubt about it. I mean, transcendent talent at the top. You pick up Zion and Ja, both could be future league MVPs. The irony is that both two guys were teammates in high school.
No figure as well.
Well, Bam just not out there to be a rim protector that time with good hands to get the steals. Kendrick Nunn playing at Southside Chicago's Simeon High. That's the exact same high school that one Derrick Rose came from. He also played alongside Jabari Parker and won four state titles there.
Now, here's Bridges. When you look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. Junior kicks to Khan. It's in the train.
This team knows to feed Cobb every chance they get. He's just so reliable.
And those four straight titles, an Illinois record, made it 7 total in Simeon's history.
It's unbelievable stuff, and that's probably why there's great reason why Kendrick Nunn's jersey hangs there in the rafters. Only 4 players have gotten that honor. When a player gets a feel for that floater, it can really make things tough on defenders. You're just not sure how to guard them and where your point of commitment is.
And a few are missing. The Heat with the lead. Down low.
You try your best defensively to push Bam away from the rim. That's easier said than done.
Passes to Junior. Here's Juan Gomez. Tries again, and the layup is good.
He takes care of salvaging that possession for the offense by getting on the offensive glass.
Here's Jones. Lee Bellis is put in just the right spot.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. They were being pushed around on that low block.
Junior kicks to Washington. Here's Cobb. Drains it from beyond the arc. Cobb's got a pair of threes now in the first quarter for Charlotte.
And nowadays, everyone is taking three-pointers. Cobb showing you the touch from deep. Nice.
About 7 seconds separating the shot to game clocks. Here's Robinson. It's rebounded by Charlotte. And this is their first time matched up with this year's Heat team.
And they'll be seeing each other 4 times this year. This is the first meeting. Looking for a good start in the series.
Yeah, who's going to set the tone here tonight? That'll be something to watch.
Now, here's Nunn. Takes the 3. And so, both teams trading buckets as we end the first quarter. when it's ahead, up by two. Back after this from the American Airlines Arena. And we spoke with Jimmy Butler not too long ago about his teammates.
These guys are so far in there young and professional looking that you kind of see early. So they can only get better and they're learning and they're getting confidence because they're playing so well. So with me being here with these guys, we're special.
Great. It sounds like Butler is found it. Some kind of whole new group on the floor now for Charlotte. And it's the Heat with the ball. 1 point lead, the biggest of the game. Shots good by Hero.
Pretty much having the green light on the offensive end. Tyler Hero gets explosive to score.
Jay Crowder. Then it's Ben Adebayo. And it's Hero into the shooting guard. It's the group on the floor for Miami.
And that play never gets old. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
And it's Dragic with the ball for the Heat, coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
When they ran the offense right, they found some easy shots, but on that occasion, it was few and far between.
Yeah, lots of ups and downs. One good possession, two bad ones, one good one. We could never get on a steady run and play some solid offense.
And let's catch up with our Charlotte reporter, David Oliver.
Hey, Kevin, thanks. If you ask Miami coach Eric Spoelstra, there's been a long lineage of undrafted players who made an impact with the Heat. Going back, think about big guys like Udonis Haslem, Joel Anthony, and Hassan Whiteside. Now you have youngsters like Kendrick Nunn, Duncan Robinson, Derrick Jones Jr., and Chris Silva. Miami continues to find diamonds in the rough year after year. Guys,
they usually do. That's a very creative organization. Thanks, D.A. Here's Beyond Button after the made shot from Jay Crowder. Platoon passes to Junior. Look at six. Second chance effort. If it goes in, and Miami Lewis cut to just 7 points in the basket for Beyond Button.
That's a testament to the effort there on the boards. Never willing to give up on the possession. Finding ways to sniff out the ball.
Now here's Dragic. He's got nine. And now, this one for three. Shots good by Hero. Hero's got the lead up to 10 now for the Heat.
Nice pass here to set that basket up.
Hornets shooting 44% from the field in the second. To the paint. Here's Junior. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
You can clearly see Junior is still a customer. Every game, every play, he's out here giving his absolute all.
And both free throws good for Junior.
Yeah, in this quarter, they've had the right approach, driving and drawing, initiating contact, create opportunity to get to the
line. And the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a 3-point play chance right here for the free throw coming up. The Heat shooting their fourth attempt at the free throw line right here.
It's interesting to watch him because he's putting his body on the line to get to the line. We didn't see this during the first quarter, but he's making up for it here.
That's good, and it throws Giro with the assist. 6 points for Junior.
If you grew up like Junior in a basketball family, you play lots of pickup ball, and you better know how to make a shot if you're going to get knocked around.
And so that's the end of the first half. He lead by...
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
That's different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three. And for those of you just just tuning in, thanks for being with us. The second half of this game is still to play. An almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. Rambo is checked in for Washington. Miles Bridges comes in for Nicholas Batum. Von Schuppens checked in for Malik Monk. And Junior sub in for Roshi. Does that bother you?
Nah, I mean, people like to say, well, our hero had the rivalries a little more bitter. I disagree with that. I think guys are every bit as competitive today as they've ever been.
It's good to hear.
They just also have more exposure and opportunity to be around them. Kids today growing up, they've been playing against each other since the fifth, sixth grade in national tournaments. When we played, we didn't get to see the other top players around the country. So I think that was one reason why we didn't have a closeness with guys unless you were on the same team.
And Charlotte, looking at who they've got, inside Cody Zeller and Bismack Biyombo. Junior's out there with the minor shot, and Bridges in at the three, a small four. And the foul called on Junior. That's foul number two for him. A different look for Miami. Jay Crowder comes in for Bam Adebayo. And it's going for Derrick Jones. Nothing that's good.
Excellent play. Just adding fuel to the fire and really trying to put this one out of reach.
This is what great players try to do. They're not allowing the opposition to gain any kind of hope to try and get back in the game.
Robinson misses. Hornets trail by 12. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And Butler sends it back.
Butler with great anticipation there and spotting that one.
And now another look at that mobile one block defensive performance.
Emphatic with the rejection. You've got to appreciate that kind of forceful defense. And Bones, when you look at Jimmy Butler's elite impact at both ends, you could argue he's the best two-way shooter in the NBA.
Clay Thompson might have something to say about that, GA, but certainly Jimmy Butler and his physical presence allows him to play a multitude of positions. So sliding down to the three and getting physical is something that Jimmy will do. We know that he'll take on any assignment and compete with him.
And the Hornets making the change here. Washington's checked in. Nicholas Batum, he's checked in for the Hornets. We've got 28 seconds left to play in the third. Now, here's Nunn. Defense is right there. And it's blocked. And here we go. Fast break. Junior's got it. And the layup's good off the glass. Junior's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Capitalizing on the break and out hustling your opponent. There's the reward for Junior.
16-15. And he gets the final spin in that one drops. And the Heat lead by 14. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit. We'll make it tough to come back. Heat out front, leading by 14. And when we return, we'll get the third quarter rolling on here on 2K Sports. And now let's go back to a play from earlier as we show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass.
Well, there's a way to break down the defense with the handle, but you can do it with the pass. Prime example of that right there.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. As we get going in quarter number four, we've got Jay Crowder. He's out there with Kelly Olynyk. Jimmy Butler is out there with Robinson. And it's Dragic in at the point guard position. That's the group on the floor for Miami. Miami leading by 12. Against the pass to Butler. Outside Robinson. Crowder feeling it out a bit. And a dunk by Olynyk.
Kelly Olynyk right now is a big time move.
And the Hornets draw time here. What you love about Crowder, he gives you a little bit of everything at both ends.
I mean, defensively, he'll take off anybody. He's smart, draws a lot of charges. Offensively, he can stretch the floor and he'll make the extra things. He's also an opportunistic rebound.
falls through. It's his sixth make from the floor this game, now 6 for 10.
He's put on a shooting display here in the second half. He really seems to be in a great groove right now.
Hodges gets the drop. A two against Butler. To the wing right side. Hodges with a ball. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back.
And forever a small kick. I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion.
Guys open at the 3-point line.
Lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
And you can see the floor awareness there. Junior more than capable of spotting the open teammate.
There's 1:54 left to play in the final quarter. And it's Trogic off the drive. And it's good for two. And the Heat lead by 17.
We're in total command of this game. With time.
Looking for a miracle worker out there is the opposing coaching staff. I don't know that they have. This game seems to be well in hand.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Hero passes to Crowder. Shoots over Washington.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Heat.
They found a great rhythm from long range.
Yeah, Kevin, every time they left a man open deep, he'd get a good shot at the basket, didn't hesitate, and that aggression paid off.
And so with this win, they'll move to 6 victories on the season.
And against a conference opponent, always good to take that first win of the season series to establish a psychological edge.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Bam Adebayo.
He did all the dirty work that they needed, clearing out space underneath and securing rebounds.
And here's Dragic. He'll bring it up for Miami. 54 seconds left in the fourth quarter. To the wing on the left. It's Adebayo, top of the key. And it's good for back to the rim and out.
Finishing strong. This is how you want to close things out.
Yeah, definitely putting a stamp on this one. A very, very decisive victory for the club tonight.
Now, here's Junior. He's guarded by Dragic. Batum passes to Junior. Great D that time from Adebayo. 1 second separating the shot clock and game. Heat moving the ball around.
This arena was rocking throughout the night. You could really feel the energy.
A huge motivation, always great for a young team, but veteran players also appreciate when fans come with that kind of energy and get into the spirit of the game.
And so Miami took this one by a big margin. There was a total of 2 teams tonight, one that was in total control, including policy. The other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. So long, everyone.